Hi, everybody, and officially welcome back to Fig Review. Look, it's the Hari Suzumiya that we saw in my last video. It wasn't like there was like an outcry or anything, but more than one person mentioned the Haruhi Suzumiya figure scale by name. So here she is. We're gonna take a look at her. We're gonna take a look on the outside box. Of course, we got the front with the clear where you can see through. It's got all the text on the side. Just general cute designs on the side as well, just showing the figure off. This is a Kadokawa figure. I mentioned this in my last video. For some reason, I thought it was a Good Smile. It's not. I don't know where that came from, but whatever. But yeah, there she is. It's a cute generic box. You get to see all the different poses because she does have two poses that she comes with. And just some general art, I think, you know, that just complements the show style. And it's a pretty standard box, nothing super outstanding. And we got the top, the original Haruhi Suzumiya. No fakes here. And the bottom. Let's go ahead, get her out of the box, and see what she's all about. So here is her basic packaging. I mean, it's again, just a normal shell where you got the front, back, no extra pieces or anything. She's got instructions that are in the bottom. And in case you're curious, there is a removable sleeve that just says Haruhi Suzumiya. You know, it's there. Yo, wait, look at this instructions though. These ones are pretty straightforward, but like, look at the freaking displayer. She looks like an octo arm. Boom! We have her base, just because it's there. It came in its own little baggie, but I think she's got a nice, simple, cute base. It's nothing crazy. Weird. I don't know why that's weird. Because everywhere else it says Haruhi Suzumiya, but on the base it says Suzumi Haruhi, and I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, I guess. But it looks simple. It looks, but it's got the metal rods to keep it sturdy, so I'm not mad about that. Now she... not too complicated here. She's got a plastic wrap, neck wrap, arm protection, and it wraps around her waist. And then her separate faces and her head have their own bag. So bag. So now that we got them both out, we're gonna attach them super easy. If it'll focus first though, hold up. Let's be professional here. Feetsy pegs on the feetsy pegs. Boom. There she is, all attached. The seam on it isn't super perfect. Like, you can kind of see where her foot and the stand are separated. That's not the end of the world, but that always does make me just feel a little bit uneasy, I guess, because it's not perfect. All right, well, there she is out of the packaging. I'm very excited to get a closer look at her. I already think she looks really good. Her styling that they did for this, I'm pretty sure is more so based off of the light novel versus the anime or the show or the movie or whatever. So I'm really excited. Already at a glance, I can see how nice the paint is. So we are gonna take a closer look. All right, so first, we are gonna start with her lovely face. So already off the bat, like I mentioned, already love the shading and everything. She has a very nice subtle amount of like pinkish orangish blush on her cheeks that I think looks really cute. Her expression, fantastic, because it's kind of, it's a little bit softer, but she still looks kind of smug and annoying, which is important. It's Haruhi, you know how it goes. They have her eyes. Now, they're not like super duper shiny or anything like that. There is a little bit of a shine depending on how the light hits it, but most of the design comes from the actual paint on the decal itself. And there's like all the different browns that they use for her, not only in her eye and her iris. So like there's at least the three different colors of brown and then like the two white highlights, but also in her actual eyelashes, they touch on the inner corners with that like kind of orange brown, red brown. So I think they did a fantastic job at shading this. Her hair as well, also really nicely done. She of course has her classic orange ribbon sticking out from the sides as well. Again, all shaded very, very nicely. And then once you get into like some of these parts, it gets a little bit darker and then it gets like a little bit lighter. It's very, very subtle. You can see it a little bit more on her bangs here with how it's shaded on this front part. Again, it's very slight though, but I think it's just the right amount. The bows are a lot more noticeable though. You can see it's all this kind of like bright orange paint and a little bit more of a light orange on this front one here. Her hair is fantastic though. Look how full her hair is. Like, there's so many like little strands sticking out, like, and overlapping each other. It just kind of gives it a lot of movement, even with how like stationary the actual pose itself is. You can kind of feel, I guess, either like the wind or like the actual energy in her with how her hair and her ribbons are blowing out, and it just looks really, really cute. This figure, it really stood out to me because of like just the amount of energy that there was in this figure, especially for a Haruhi figure. You kind of have to have a lot of energy, but a lot of the figures I think are really old now or just not as nice looking as this one is, so I was really excited. Moving along though, we have her actual school uniform. This is just like a classic look. Like, it's Haruhi Suzumiya. She was a notable face in anime for a long time and still is. The light blues are all, you know, just very subtly shaded. Probably most of that's not going to stand out. I think you can kind of see how there's the darker blue here and like this really light baby blue there. The insignia, the school little M, whatever it is, printed on the front. No shading on the red. I was gonna be really impressed if they did that, but they did do a very nice job of lining it all the way around the actual school uniform itself. It's very clean all the way around to the back as well. You can see a little bit more of that shading on the back here with the kind of more tealish blue. I think, again, really good job. Now the white, interestingly enough, if it is shaded, it's super light where I can't really see it. I don't believe the white is shaded though, so it's just nicely sculpted where you can see all the folds as it falls into her arms. Her little fingies. Wow, little fingies, which I think have a little bit of gloss on them. She got glossy nails. I love glossy nails. I wish more anime characters had colored nails, but you know, whatever. Her school band, armband, I forget what that meant. Wasn't it like director or something? Either way, her armband is how you know it's the actual light novel version too, because I don't think they had all these little white things on it in the show, which I do like. They're a little bit distracting. Ooh, that moves a lot. I guess it's a good thing and a bad thing. It moves a lot, but if it drops, it's not gonna be the thing that breaks, because anything that small would break the moment it dropped. And honestly, it wouldn't even have to drop. I would probably just take it out of the container and it would have broken if it wasn't malleable. So, you know, it is a little bit distracting just because I'm not used to it, but I don't think it's a bad thing. It's just because I'm not used to it, you know what I mean? Her red ribbon peeking out of the bottom, it's a much deeper, darker maroon at the top, and it goes into the lighter maroon towards the end. Her belt and the belt loop sticking out here, I kind of wish, it's not a big thing, but I kind of wish that the belt itself was a darker blue, like just barely darker than the actual skirt. I do think they kept the color the same all the way around, but I wish it was more distinct, because you can see the belt loops going over the belt, but it's the exact same color. So I don't know. In her skirt, you can see all the different actual seam lines for like how it was sewn, which I think is cool. And I love how the skirts are just made in general, where they have like the two pleats on the front, all the really nice folds on the side, and all the super nice shading. It's super obvious here. I mean, you can see all the different details on it there, especially with all the creasing. So I think this looks fantastic. Moving right along, nice plain legs, a little bit of pink shading on the backs of her knees and a little bit underneath. Not a whole lot. It's very subtle on the actual knees itself, but it's there. Her dark socks, there is a little bit of shading where it's like darker at the top and a little bit lighter on these big broad pieces. Very, very subtle though, so maybe not easy to pick up. Nothing new. Her loafy loafs, also great. And they're also shaded nicely. I mean, you can see these ones are pretty easy to see, I think, with like the light browns and the dark browns. I love all the folds. We want to see her other face. So the instructions say to remove this arm first and this arm second. Makes sense. That one's on top. Got them off. It was a bit hard. I think because it's the winter time, they're a little bit stiff, but here are the two arms separately here. So this goes like that. That goes like this. They're pretty interlapped, so it actually kind of made it hard to take them off, but I got them off in the end. If you're curious, this is what they look like on the back side. This hand is not a hand. It's gone. It is nub
But we're gonna get her face off too. You take the hair off, you take the face off, and you put the new face in. So bald, much easier to take off and a little bit different. I haven't seen one that has like pegs like this before, but way, 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 way easier to take off. And in case you're curious what her face looks like, just completely off. Pretty cute. Very sculpted. She got big old monkey ears. Monkey ears. But it's cute though. I like it. All right, let's get her arm bees on and her new face. And in case you just wanted to see number one by itself, I guess. Here it is. It's nothing spectacular. It's the arm. And arm number two. This one's a bent arm. Kind of looks funny off of it because it's like fist bump arm. And her other face. Go ahead and figure I'd show you this before I put it in. Ears and everything are the same, but you know, there it is. Oh, look, there's a little black mark on it. Love that. It wiped off, luckily. It was just, of course, the first thing I noticed. So we're gonna reassemble her with the new parts here. Very easy. Hey, okay, dab me up. Okay, the arms are tough. I don't know why it's tough on both of them, but okay, the one arm, her pointing arm, super easy. The one that's like kind of bent is not really vibing with me. There we go. She's mostly got her arms in. You can see if you're looking, like, see how there's a little bit of a gap there. It's not the worst thing in the world, but definitely not the best. And it's not really super noticeable on the front. Now, I'm not going to say you can't see it because you definitely can, but I was struggling with it a bit. Now, the other arm, look at that. Basically can't even tell. But her face fully in, very cute. Now, honestly, I don't know which one I like better. I like both of them. They're both good poses. They're both good faces. I think this one's like, look how cute that is. Having her pointing at you from a distance. This is just, you know, classic other Haruhi pose. She's either pointing at you and laughing at you, or she's just staring menacingly at you. So, you know, pick your battles. But I think this is really cute though. I mean, like, look how good that looks. I don't know which one I like more. Which one do you like more? Do you like more? Did you think you would see the undies? Not before you pay the doubloons. Pay the doubloons. He's doing a sniff check. That good? All right, that seems good. Good, good wares. Because you've been such a good traveler. You also get one spin with the doubloon. Thank you. Be safe on your travels and don't stare too close at the booty. Now, be gone. All right, well, Sir Cathaniel left, but he left his other doubloon that's not the same doubloon that I just used to put in the doubloon machine. Let's put Anya back. She's gonna give us good luck. Uh-oh. Oh! For you, a shiny rock. All the lines to represent how many paths you have in your life, so make sure to choose the best ones. But if you don't, there's plenty of options, so don't get too stressed about it. Doubloon tips. We're not gonna get Cathaniel on every single one of those though. That was a lot of stress for him, I'm pretty sure. But most importantly, now that you've paid the toll, we can officially flip it over. It's white. What did we really expect? I don't know, man. I just want not white. But, you know, at this point, I'm an adult. So I just move on. You should, too. All right, but let's get her reset and get to this end of this video. This is kind of a crazy video. I hope y'all like that. I can't wait for that to officially be a dead meme by the time that I post this. Alright guys, well that's gonna bring us to the end of the video. I really liked Haruhi. It's a simple figure, but it looks really nice. The paint's super clean, the sculpt's really clean. Not the most dynamic figure that I have, but like the actual hair and like again the fabric just was really nice. It was painted well. I think both faces are really good. Both sets of arms are really good. Like both are really good poses, and it comes with multiple poses, so there's that first of all. So she's great. Haruhi's a little bit dated now. It doesn't really all 100% hold up to the test of time either, but I still liked what it was. And I still think the design's really cute. So, like, you can't fault me for that. It's cute. She's a good figure. But I'm going to be posting more pictures of her on my Instagram. That's just for figures. That is at Desunosis. I post figures, pictures of all my other figures that I have. It's figures. Woo! I also have now a Discord. I will share like some of the things that I get like along the way. We'll talk about other things. I would love to see you guys there. I like my Discord, so I'm just saying it'd be pretty cool if you popped in too. And there's all these other places you can find me as well. We have my personal Instagram where I post things like art and cosplay. And then there is my Patreon as well, where you can see the full versions of these videos uploaded. And the ones that have the cats in them are definitely exciting. Yeah, I thank you guys again so much for watching to the end of the video. If you're still here at the end of the video though, you should subscribe and stick around. I'm back to making videos regularly so you can see more figures. Erza! Woo! Erza, you need your doubloon? Here you go. Oh, Erza's generous. She gives you the doubloon. Wow, you lost one and you gained one. You're welcome, guys. Oh, Cathaniel's back.
He's on the hunt for doubloons.
Okay, well, Cathaniel's come back to join us for this last second, but I hope you had a great rest of your last week, and I hope you have a great rest of your next week, and I'll see you guys later. Bye! Thank you.